Hello everyone, welcome to this session of class 9 mathematics, and I'm your Anu from mathschool.1. Today's class, it is going to be lines and transversals. Parallel lines and transversals we have seen, isn't it? We have seen the concept, and we have also seen what are the angles made by the transversal with the two parallel lines. And now we'll take up some problems in this concept and we'll find out what is what. Okay. Now the first one is, see, we have two lines and we can name them as AB and CD. They are parallel to each other. Okay, you have two parallel lines and a transversal. See, a falling line on both the lines, so that it makes angles with both the lines which are parallel to each other. Okay, so I have explained you angles, the relationship between the angles formed by the transversal with the parallel lines. We have seen corresponding angles. See, this angle and this angle, this particular angle, these are corresponding angles, and x and y are what we have seen, alternate interior angles, because they are within the parallel lines. And these two angles, see, this angle and this angle are corresponding, 50 degrees and 50, and this angle, that is the angle linear path to this 130 degree and this 50, are corresponding angles, so they have to be equal. Okay, so alternate interior angles, and we have also seen the vertically opposite angles. That is what we have seen before, isn't it? Vertically opposite angles and linear pair of angles we have also seen. Now we'll apply all those things here along with the transversal concept also. Now what we need to find out is, we need to find out x and y. So first, what we take is, we take the x part. Now we see that this x and 50 degree, the adjacent angle 50 degree, lies on the transversal, isn't it? So it lies on the straight line. So I have always told you to look for a straight line where the angles are given, so that it will be easy for us to find out, because angles adjacent to each other on a straight line forms a linear pair, isn't it? So x and 50 are linear pair. So what we get? X plus 50 is equal to 180 degrees we have, isn't it? Therefore, x is equal to 180 minus 50, that is equal to 130. Now we need to justify the statement here. X plus y is equal to 180, because since it's a linear pair. Okay, since it's a linear pair, they both add up to 180 degree, and x is equal to 130 degree. As I told you before, this, see, this x and this 130 degree. See, here it is 130 degree and here it is also 130 degree. Isn't it? Do you understand? So, because this is, because x is equal to 130 degree, this is because, see, we have these two are corresponding angles. See, the angle below the line here by the transversal and the angle below the line here with the transversal. So they are both 130 degree. Okay, we can conclude like that. Also, we can see, so this 50 degree is equal to this also, because these two angles are corresponding angles. The angle above the line, the angle above the line. See, these two are same because they are corresponding angles, 50 degrees. So this is 130 degree. Therefore, this is also 130 degree. Okay, so you just follow the linear pair. If at all not possible, you just follow the linear pair, which will be very simple for you to find out. So x is equal to 130 degree we have found out. Now what about y here? See, y, we have 130 degree here and y here. These two are vertically opposite angles. Okay, so like that, we'll be able to find out 130 degrees. Y is equal to 130 degrees. But if we use the concept of transversals on parallel lines, then we see that, see, x here is equal to y here, because x and y are, see, x is equal to y because they both are, since they are alternate interior angles. Understand? Alternate interior angles. So how do they form alternate interior angles? See, this x and this y, they are alternate, okay, and they are within the parallel lines. So likewise, this angle and this 50, they have to be equal because they are also alternate interior angles. So this is 50 anyway, because we found this to be 130 degree. So we have found this to be 130 degree. So 130 plus 50 has to be 180, because they fall on the line CD, isn't it? So therefore, this 50, 50, it's getting equal. So this 130 has to be y because they are equal. Alternate interior angles are equal by one way. We can prove it like that. And 130 and y are vertically opposite angles. So y has to be 130. Okay. So x is equal to 130. Therefore, y is also equal to 130 because alternate interior angles are equal. Otherwise, we can see 50 and y are linear pair. Again, they form a linear pair. So 50 plus 130 will give you 180 degrees. And y is also equal to 180 there. So by any method you can conclude the unknown angle for y or x by any method you can find out. Okay, it is not that we need to follow this method. If at all they give a transversal or parallel lines with the transversal, this has to be mentioned there. It is not like that. You can follow any one of the facts or any, you can search for any of the option to find out the unknown angles. Okay, but what we are seeing here is we apply the concept or we apply the knowledge of transversal here to find out the value of y, that is alternate interior angles are equal, so x is equal to y, we have seen. Okay, so likewise the second sum goes. See, we have in the second sum they have marked all the angles here which are made by the transversal with the parallel lines. See, there are four lines around this point. Okay, let us take it as O dash. So four angles formed at this point and another four angles formed at this point. Let us take the lines to be AB and CD and the transversal to be L. Okay, now what is given here? If any one of the angle is given, it is sufficient. If any one angle is given out of the eight, we'll be able to find out the rest of the angles. See, if one is given, one angle is given, then we'll be able to find out three, isn't it? Because vertically opposite angle are equal, so we'll be able to find out 3, or with 1 we'll be able to find out 2 because they form a linear pair, so we need to add both of them to get 180 degree. By that way we'll be able to find out 2. After finding 2 we'll be able to find out 4 because those two are vertically opposite angles, or with 3 also we can find out 4 because it forms a linear pair. And after finding 4, see, 4 and 6 are equal because they are alternate interior angles. And 3 and 5 are equal, they are also alternate interior angles. And 2 and 6 are equal because they are corresponding angles. Yes, right. Corresponding angles. Likewise, 1 and 5 are also equal because they are corresponding angles. See, 4 and 8 has to be equal because they are corresponding angles. And 3 and 7 are also equal because they are also corresponding angles. Okay, by any way we can find out all the angles. If just one angle is given, it is sufficient. We'll be able to find out all the angles. Now what they have given is, they have given angle 1 is to angle 2 is equal to 3 is to 2. They have given the ratio of two angles. Okay, so if the ratio of two angles are given, how do we proceed? I've always told you, if the ratio is given, just take them to be 3x and 2x. Okay, so angle 1 is 3x and angle 2 is 2x. You just take both of them and see how does 1 and 2 appear to be. They form a linear pair because they lie on the line AB, isn't it? So I write 3x plus 2x is equal to 180 degree, because they form a linear pair. Okay, please do write the justification alongside of the equation, because you need to know how do you arrive at the equation. Okay, so 3x plus 2x is equal to 180 degree, because angle 1 plus angle 2 is equal to 180 degrees, because it forms a linear pair. Okay, so 3x plus 2x is 5x is equal to 180. Therefore x is equal to 5 3s are 15, 36 degrees. So x is equal to 36 degree we have found out. So what is x? X is equal to 36 degree. Now what is angle 1 here? Now we'll start finding each and every angle. So angle 1 is equal to, what is it? Angle 1 is 3x, isn't it? So 3x, that is 3 into 36 is 3 6 3s are 18 108. Okay, so angle 1 is 108 we have found. So what this has to be, even without calculating with this ratio, we'll be able to find out. If it is 108, what is 2? Yes, it forms a linear pair. So what is 2? It is 72, isn't it? It is 72, because let us check it out. 2x is equal to 2 into 36, which is 72. So it's right. Okay, so that is 72. Now we'll start finding out the other angles. If this is 72, this has to be 72. because 2 and 4, see, 2 and 4 are vertically opposite angles. Okay, do remember 2 and 4 are vertically opposite angles, and even 1 and 3 are vertically opposite angles. So this is 108. If 4 is 72, what about 6? So that is also 72, because angle 4 and angle 6 are alternate interior angles. So they are also equal. 4 and 6 are alternate interior angles, so they have to be equal. So 72, if this is 72, this is also 72. And the 3 and 5 are also alternate interior angles. So if this is 108, this also has to be 108. If this is 108, if 5 is 108, angle 7 has to be 108, because the vertically opposite angles are equal. If 6 is 72, this is also 72. See how we have obtained 108 plus 72. 72 plus 108, totally 360 degree around a point, and here 180 plus 180, 360 around a point. So you got it right, isn't it? So that is how we find angles formed by the transversal on two parallel lines. Okay, so keep in mind the corresponding angles are equal, alternate interior angles are equal, and alternate exterior angles are also equal. So what do you mean by alternate exterior angles? See, angle 1 is here and angle 7 is here. Exterior, that is outside the parallel line. So this is, 1 is exterior angle. So just opposite, just diagonal, put a diagonal to it. So 7, this is alternate exterior angle. See, this is 108 and this is 108. Likewise, 2 and 8 are equal because they are alternate exterior angles, that is 72 degrees. Do you understand? So those two angles are also equal. Alternate interior angles, alternate exterior angles, corresponding angles, 72. See, 2 and 6, both are 72, isn't it? So corresponding angles are also equal, and then vertically opposite angles are equal. So vertically opposite angles are equal, we have seen that. The next two things which are supplementary, that is linear pair form supplementary angles, we know that is, if we add both the angles, it gives you 180 degrees. That is 1 and 2, 108 plus 72 is, yes, 180. Likewise, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 1. If you add them, you get 180 degrees. So they form a linear pair, or they are supplementary. We say they are supplementary. Likewise, 3 and 6. See, adjacent next angles next to them. 3 and 6. They are not opposite, but they are interior angles which are next to each other. Consecutive interior angles. They are called consecutive interior angles. Next angles. So consecutive interior angles are supplementary. Likewise, see, 4 and 5 are supplementary. Do you understand? So consecutive interior angles are supplementary. Likewise, the lines which are on the line, I mean the angles which are adjacent to each other and they are on the line are also supplementary. That is the linear pair. Okay? So do understand all these concepts so that you will be able to apply in these problems and you will get the answers very easily, very quickly. Okay, so please take a note of it while we continue with the next question. So we continue with the next question now. Please don't forget to write the justification by the side of the equation you write, because you need to know how did you get that equation, how did you arrive at the equation. You need to explain how did you get it, right? So next one is third one. Now we have two lines AB parallel to CD. Okay, see, I'm drawing this AB, CD are parallel to each other. Okay, now they have given you a line here. See, there is a line, and this point is P here, and this is Q, and this is R. Okay, so angle APQ is 50 degrees, and angle PRD. Angle PRD is 127 degrees, and you need to find X as well as Y. Okay, so this is the sum they have given you. See, you have two parallel lines AB and CD, and you are given with the angles, angle APQ is equal to 50 degrees, angle PRD is equal to 127 degrees. So you need to find X and Y now. Okay, so where is X and Y here? Okay, so please don't panic while you see such kind of problems with drawing like this. It is nothing but two parallel lines and a transversal. That's it. See, when I extend this line PQ, see, it looks like a transversal, isn't it? It looks like a transversal. See, AB and CD are two parallel lines and PQ is just a transversal here. So now when you see the line extended, you see, I got it, 50 and X are, how they are now? So they are equal, isn't it? So because 50 and X are alternate interior angles, that's it. So you get the answer in just one line. So X is equal to 50 degrees. How you need to give the reasoning? Because they are alternate interior angles and they are equal, isn't it? So they are equal. So you got the answer. First one, X is equal to 50 degrees. You have obtained 50 degrees now. Now, what about this Y? How do I get this Y now? So now, observe this carefully. Now, I am extending this line, this transversal. See, forget about this line. Now, I have extended PR now. Okay? So, PR is a transversal now. PR is a transversal. See, I have got 127 here. So, what about this line? What about the angle here? It is, see, it is a total angle here. If this is 127, this is the total angle here, isn't it? Do you understand? You forget about this line. See, I just rub it for a while. I just rub this line for a while. See, you have this transversal PR and this is the angle formed here and the angle 127 here. So, how are they now? Now, can you identify the angles here? See this angle and this? Yes, they are alternate interior angles. Okay, so 50 plus Y, anyway, 50 plus Y is the angle here and 127 is the angle there. So what happens? 50 plus Y should be equal to 127 degrees. Why? Because the same reason, alternate interior angles. Okay, so we have got Y is equal to 127 minus 50. So what happens? 7 minus 0 is 7, 12 minus 5 is 77. So Y is equal to 77. So let's check whether it is right or wrong. See, X is equal to 50 and Y is equal to 77 we have obtained. Just take the triangle here. See, if this is 127, what about this angle? We'll just check. We are checking it whether we have done it right or not. Okay. So 127, this is 127, what about this angle? Those two form a linear pair, isn't it? So if they form a linear pair, then what about this? 180 minus 127 will give you 3, 7 minus 5, 7 minus 2 is 5. So this will become 53 now. Okay, so you have obtained 53. Of course, it is not asked in the question. What is the angle here? It is not asked. But we are doing it just to confirm whether we have got the answers right. So 53 here. Okay, now if you see PQR forms a triangle, isn't it? So in a triangle, we know for a triangle, the sum of all angles has to be 180 degrees, okay? So 77 plus 50 plus 53, what happens? 77 plus 53 plus 50, see 10, 12, 17 and 100. So we got it right, okay? So the angles we have obtained are correct. You understand? So that is how you find out the angles, and this is optional. Actually, you don't have to find out 53 degrees and you don't have to find the angle the sum of all angles in a triangle is 180. You just, it's not needed, but just for our confirmation, we are just checking it whether it is right or wrong. So Y is equal to 77 and X is equal to 50 is the answer for this problem. So how did we arrive at it? We used alternate interior angles are equal property. Okay, so just take a note of it. We'll move on to the next problem. next one is fourth one. See, we have the, a similar problem. We have two parallel lines here, AB and CD. Just whenever you do a problem, just draw it line by line, step by step you draw it and see, so that you will have a clear picture, and by drawing, through drawing itself, we'll be able to understand many such facts which are involved in it. Okay, so now what we have is, we have two lines intersecting at O here. Okay, we have two lines from AB and CD which are, which intersects at O, point 2. Okay, now this angle is given as 55 degrees and this to be 38 degrees. Okay, they have given you like this, and what I am doing is, see, just a line, an imaginary line is drawn, because there are two angles here, angle 1 and angle 2 here. Okay, so we need to find angle 1 and angle 2 here, and we also need to find angle A here. So that is the total angle. So total angle anyway can be obtained by just adding 1 and 2. Okay, just adding 1 and 2. So what is the problem is, now I'll redraw it. So this is a point A and you need to find the angle A here. Okay, so these two lines intersect at O here, and you need to find the, what is that? You need to find the angle A. So what we need to do is, we draw a line here in between and we mark this as 1 and this as 2. So A will be angle 1 plus angle 2. Now do you understand? So we need to find the angle A, that is the angle made by these two lines, is the angle A, for which we draw a line here. So we know, if these two lines are parallel, see, these two lines are parallel and I am drawing a line. See, these two lines intersect at O and I am drawing a line in between. So these two lines are also parallel to each other. Okay, this line is parallel to both the lines AB and CD, such that I draw a line like it. So it is parallel to AB and CD. Okay, and now when, if this is 55, let me redraw it again here. See, I have just this. This is 55 degrees. Okay, so this is 55 degrees and this is angle 1. Now do you understand this, the drawing? Okay, so now it will be very easy for you to find out angle 1. What it is? It is just the same, the alternate interior angle, which is 55 degrees. So angle 1 is equal to 55 degrees, we have formula. So this is 55 degrees. Now then the same case we have here. See, the between line here and here another line. We have a line in between here. And this is 38 degrees. If this is 38 degrees, then what about the angle 2? So just the same, isn't it? Alternate interior angles, they are equal. So angle 2 is also equal to 38 degrees. So we have got 38 degrees. So what happens? A is equal to, now we have got A is equal to 55 plus 38, which is equal to 93 degrees. So A is equal to 93 degrees, we have obtained, isn't it? So A is equal to 93 degrees. How we have got? So we have drawn a line in between which passes through O and it is parallel to both AB and CD. So we take these two lines and the transversal, it is like a transversal here, and then these two lines with the transversal here, and we are finding out the two angles separately and we just add them to get A. Now did you understand? Yes. Now this is how we proceed with this sum. Just take a note of it. Okay. Now the next sum is fifth one. So a similar problem, you can approach it the similar way we did for the previous sum. So just a revision so that you will be able to understand. And this is 112 degrees and this is x. So you need to find x degrees. See, this is a problem here. You have 108 degree, 112 degree. These two lines are parallel. Okay, so these two lines are parallel and there is a I mean, there is a point here from which two lines to the parallel line are drawn, and at this point you have an angle x degree. So you need to find x degree. Okay, so now how do we proceed with this? We just draw a line in between. So we have two parallel lines now here with a transversal. And what can you say about this? Earlier we had this angle. Okay, in the previous problem we had this angle, so we said alternate interior angles are equal, and we found out. Now what can we say about these two angles? What are these two angles? See, I draw it separately. If you have a line like this transversal, see, these are the two angles which we are concerned now. So what are these two angles? I told you, on the same side if you have angles, they are consecutive interior angles. See, interior angles within the lines you have, and they are consecutive on the same side. So they are consecutive interior angles. So what about consecutive interior angles? Yes, consecutive interior angles are supplementary. Yes. So 108 degrees plus, let us take this as angle 1 and this is angle 2. Okay, this is just 1. Sorry, 1, angle 1, and this is angle 2. So angle 1 is equal to 180 degrees. So angle 1 is equal to 180 minus 108, which is equal to 72. Okay, so this is 72. What is it? 72 degrees. So how did we obtain both these things? 108 plus 1 is equal to 180 degree. Our justification is because they are consecutive interior angles. Consecutive interior angles, and they are supplementary. So we add them and put 180 degrees there. So this is 72 degrees. Okay, likewise we have 112 here. And what can we say about this angle? See, we have a line here. This is 112 degree and this is angle 2 here. So these two angles are also consecutive interior angles. Therefore 112 plus angle 2 is equal to 180 degrees. Or angle 2 is equal to 180 minus 112, which will give you 8, and 112 minus 80, so that is 10, so 28 degrees. So 8, 7, that is 68 degrees. Okay, 180 minus 12. Yes, right. 68 degrees. So this is angle 2 is 68 degrees here. Okay, so 112 plus 68 will give you 180, because both the angles are consecutive interior angles. Do you understand? So 68 and 112. So what about x now? X is equal to, see, this 2 is 68 degrees, isn't it? So what about x? 72 plus 68, that is nothing but 140 degrees. So x is equal to 140 degrees. X is equal to 140 degrees. Do you understand? So 140 degrees will be your angle in between. When you add both the angles, you get angle x. Do you understand? So we have now understood what are consecutive interior angles. And consecutive interior angles are supplementary. Please don't get confused. They are not equal. They are supplementary. Okay? So take it down, please. Now the next one is, see, we have two lines here. We have a line here and we have a line here. See, we have two lines here. So earlier we had lines on the same side. We have now different lines here. See, and we have, this is C, B, C, D, and this is A, and this is E. Now, okay, now what we need to do, see, they have given you AB is parallel to D, okay. This line AB is parallel to D for you. And now, what we need to do is, we need to prove angle ABC plus angle BCD plus angle, is equal to 180 degrees plus angle CD. Now note it down. See, angle ABC
angle ABC, so this angle plus angle BCD, this angle, see both these angles are equal to just 180 degrees plus CD. Okay, so how do we prove that ABC plus BCD is equal to 180 plus CD? Okay, now 180, it's a number here, and ABC is an angle we know, and CD is also an angle. Now what about BCD? Now BCD, as in the previous problems, let us split them into angle 1 and angle 2. Okay, so I have split them into angle 1 and angle 2. So why I have split them, you will understand. See, I have split them into 1 and 2. Now you take this line and this. You take these two lines, okay? You forget about this. You just take these two lines. Now, how about this angle ABC? How about this angle and angle 2? You just observe. See these two lines and a line here you have. Okay. See, angle, this is angle 2 and this is angle ABC. Now, what can you say about both these angles? Yes, we have done previously, isn't it? So, consecutive interior angles. They are supplementary. So, we can write angle ABC plus angle 2 is equal to 180 degrees. Let us keep it as equation 1. Okay, because these two angles are supplementary, it adds up to 180 degrees. So it becomes the equation 1 now. Now the next thing is, let us take these two lines. Okay, so when you take these two lines, it is just like, see, I'll redraw this. ED is here. This is D and this is E. Okay, DE is here and there is a line here, and I have drawn the line in between. So this is the line in between, and there is an angle here and this is angle 1. So this is CD, this is CDE, and this is angle 1 and this is angle CD. Now what can you say about these two angles? Angle CDE and angle 1? Yes. Angle CDE and angle 1 are equal, isn't it? Angle CDE and angle 1 are equal. So angle CDE is equal to angle 1. Okay, do you understand? So angle CDE is equal to angle 1 we know here. So angle CDE is angle 1, you keep it as it is. And now let's move on to the problem here. Okay, so what happens is, now what we do is, angle 1 here, now let us take this as to be equation 1. Okay, now what is BCD? BCD is angle 1 plus angle 2, isn't it? Angle BCD is angle 1 plus angle 2, because we have split angle BCD into 1 and 2 for our convenience. So angle BCD is equal to angle 1 plus 2. See, angle 1 is here and angle 2 is in the first equation, angle 1 is in the second equation. So what we do is, we add equation 1 and 2, we add just 1 and 2, we add these two things and we add these two things. Okay, so now what happens? ABC, angle ABC plus angle 2 plus angle 1 is equal to, this side we add both these things, angle 180 plus angle CDE. See, we have obtained the right hand side angle 180 degrees plus CDE. We have obtained the RHS of the proof. Now ABC plus angle 1 and 2 is nothing but ABC plus, what is 1 and 2? BCD is equal to 180 degrees plus CDE. That's it. So we have proved ABC plus BCD is equal to 180 plus CD. Do you understand? So what we have, what are the concepts we have used here in the diagram? We have used consecutive interior angles are supplementary and alternate interior angles are equal, and we have added both the equations. What we have done is, we have added this one with left side and CDE to the right side. Okay, we have added them and we have obtained the required equation. The simple thing we have done is, we have drawn a line between here through the intersecting point. We have drawn a line and we have split them into two pairs of parallel lines. Do you understand? And we have observed when the ideas behind transversal and two parallel lines. Do you understand? So we'll continue some more problems based on the transversals so that you get a more deep idea into the concept. Okay, so until then, keep practicing, and it's bye from Manu. Thank you.